World Table Tennis Championships. We're bringing you all the best behind the scenes action this week. Two shows a day now, right the way through to the end of the event on Sunday here in Budapest. And once again, at this biggest event on the calendar, of course, over 560 players entered from over 100 nations. We've got a couple of terrific guests here to talk through what's gone on so far here on Wednesday. First of all, welcome to Galia Dvorak. Of course, Galia, you've been 15, 16 years with the Spanish national team, three-time Olympian. Great to have you on.
It's really great to be here.
Fantastic. And joining you, equally delighted to have the African table tennis star, multiple event winner in that part of the world, Omar Assar. Omar.
Thank you. Great to
welcome
be
along.
Here.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I mean, really, really good to have you both because, of course, this is the biggest event on the calendar. I mean, it must be great to be around this every time this week.
Yeah, I mean, every year before World Championships, despite I know I will not become world champion, it's the event that I get most nervous about.
You go along with that, Omar?
Yeah, of course. I mean, World Championships is the highlight of the year, and it's very nice to be here in between of the world's biggest table tennis stars, and also all the players are enjoying the tournament so far, even the players who already finished playing, and they are still watching and enjoying the competitive matches. So
honestly, really, really good to have you both here on Leaphead Live. We've got a lot to get through because, of course, the matches restart very, very shortly, about half an hour's time. Let's get to the biggest action of the day so far, the biggest upset. Former world number one, Germany's Dmitry Ovtcharov. Dima in action against Tomislav Puchar. We want to get both of you in action on this because this was a thrilling match here today. Look at some of it now here. Dima was in trouble early on, Omar. Let's get you first of all. I mean, what did you make of this?
Well, I mean, it's a huge upset today. Of course, Dima was fighting until the last point, but was not just enough to beat Puchar today while he was performing unbelievable, amazing today. Both are backhand players, and it was very nice to watch this game. Tactically, also, both were trying to prevent each other backhand, but it was a very good match from both Dima and Puchar, of course. Puchar was the one who will celebrate tonight his big victory over Dima. What do you think, Galia, about this?
Yeah, actually, I think you made a very good point talking about that. Both of them, they are backhand players. And me, myself, I'm a backhand player. So one of the things that I'm most afraid to meet, it's a player that it's also a backhand player.
Yeah.
So maybe it's how Dima felt a little bit in this match, and he suffers from it.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's a stunning upset. I mean, Dima, you're around the training hall and everything.
Yeah,
Omar.
That's true.
The word was a little bit he wasn't in the best form, but you still don't expect that. You expect maybe the player with that sort of experience to find a way, but he couldn't do it.
Well, even Dima sometimes when he's out of form, he's very fast to become back. And I could see him training in the last days in the practice hall in Düsseldorf, Germany. And he was doing very, very well, and he was looking in a very good form as well. Physically, also technically, everything was running very well, and I would expect from him to go much further, especially that he would, if he would pass Puchar today, he would play against Kukiniwa, where it's always very fun to watch this game. Last time in Düsseldorf, they had unbelievable nice match, and I was looking forward towards this match again. But today, the tactic was great that Puchar could keep seven sets trying to catch Dima on the forehand side, and more let him go very far to receive from the forehand side with his backhand, and then catch him in middle, and then bring him back again to forehand. So I was very impressed how Puchar could perform that way today against Dima. And I don't know if you looked at the match. Sometimes Dima, you feel that he's back, and then Puchar could bring him again to the same uncomfort zone, I would
say. Yeah. Right in the
middle.
Pocket, if you like.
In the pocket or very far in forehand, and it was, for me, very interesting to watch that.
I mean, a little
bit on Puchar, though. I mean, we're focusing on Dima going out here, but this is a great opportunity now for him going forward. It's the World Championships.
Yeah, actually, I have to say something that maybe it's not so much about tactics, but I saw Puchar yesterday in the bus, and I got this impression that he was looking so confident and so ready to play. You know when you pass around to some player and you get this feeling like, wow, this guy, he looks he's feeling good. And when today I saw that he won, I was like, so I got the right impression.
Yeah, also recently Puchar has been played very well last month. He was semi-final in Oman Open. This was a very very good performance he played there, and then he followed with this also
Qatar
with
Open,
very
right.
good performance yes. in Qatar Open as well. So I'm very happy for him that he could, I mean, being that stable for three big tournaments in a row. Of course, the highlight is World Championships. So it's very interesting, and I'm waiting also to watch his match against Niwa in the round of 16.
Yeah,
very, very.
We were expecting Dima against Niwa,
exactly.
but now, of course, he's got the big opportunity
yeah.
against
yeah, exactly,
the Japanese.
Yes.
Great to get your thoughts on that, of course. We invite the questions as well. Hashtag Lipair Live, if you aren't aware already. There, hashtag Lipair Live through the Twitter or the Facebook for Galia and Omar. Later in the show, we're going to try and ask you some questions, but great to get your thoughts on that already, on that big upset of the day. Now, away from things, as I say, we want to give you all the behind-the-scenes access this week at the biggest event on the ITTF calendar. And we have our reporter all this week, Su Yeon Lee, who's catching up with you guys, the players. And she's put together a lovely little piece for us today, looking at things from behind the scenes from a player's perspective.
You probably know me better with my nickname, Ping Pong Girl. In this second video, I'm going to show you the venue from the player's perspective. Right now, I'm in practice room. As you see, a lot of players are practicing right now before their matches. Small studio in the venue, so players who made it around 16 will come here and make videos and photos for their presentation when they merge into the main hall. This area, all the players have to come here 30 minutes before their match and getting final checkings. This is the portal where all the players will go through into the hall. Do you remember the small studio? All the players came to take the photos and videos for their presentation. All the presentation will show on this screen when they are coming out from here. Inside of the mixed zone where all the players will come here right after their matches and sharing their emotion and feelings, how was the match, with the media and press from all over the world. Hope you enjoyed the video and thank you so much for watching it.
Yeah, Su Yeon Lee really getting behind the scenes there, giving that from a player's perspective, and we look forward to her reports through the rest of this week here on Lipair Live. Let's crack with the action on right on now. Back to the other results away from the Ovtcharov upset. Let's look first of all at the mixed doubles, the defending champions in action there, Galia, Ishikawa and Yoshimura in action against Hungarians. It was a good atmosphere this morning. Take a look at some of that now, how that panned out.
Let's do that. I personally didn't watch the match,
But it was a great atmosphere. You were commentating, weren't you, for us for the ITTF?
I started commentating right after that, so I didn't have the opportunity to watch this match. But I heard that it was like really interesting, and despite the result and the win for the current world champions, the Hungarians, they really could put a fight, and they're really good double. They started to play together not that long ago, but they've been already having good results, and in Hungary Open earlier this year, they played pretty well.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I mean, they're obviously coming from 2-1 down in games here to keep the title defense alive. And I mean, delighted with that, weren't they, Aymar? Yeah. I mean,
also, when you see the mix between Yoshimura and Ishikawa playing together, it's for me very exciting, because Yoshimura is a very talented guy. He can do a lot with the ball. And I haven't played them with Dina Meshev in mixed doubles, but I would guess that the other girl would have a lot of problems when she receives the ball from Yoshimura, because he can do a lot, and he can always make some snakes, and also with his serve, a lot of kick serve from his side. So for me, the Hungarian pair, they did a very good job to catch two sets from Ishikawa and Yoshimura. This is a very good performance from them. And yeah, I think I would also expect more from Ishikawa and Yoshimura in the upcoming rounds, that they could even perform better.
They can improve
better
as they go on.
Yeah, this is true.
Into the tournament. Yeah. Absolutely. Moving on, of course, in the women's singles, I mean, there were so many good matches at the round of 32 stage. But one of them we want to look at specifically with you, Galia, here is Sun Ying Sha, someone we saw who's doing really, really well, Youth Olympic Games, where you were there as a mentor, against Mima Ito. I mean, this is tough for both of them to meet round of 32 stage here in Budapest. So look at some of this now with you. Tough match.
Yeah, I think probably Mima Ito, she was not very happy with this draw, because in senior events they only face each other once. And also Sun Ying Sha, she won this match before, I think, with a score 4-3. So for sure, I think Ito Mima, she was a little disappointed to get Sun Ying Sha in this round. It was actually a fantastic game, and despite the score of 4-1 for Sun Ying Sha, that it sounds like something that could be quite easy, there were three sets in a row that they were really, really close, that Sun Ying Sha, she won 11-9, 11-9, and then the next one, I think Ito Mima, she took it 13-11. So despite Sun Ying Sha, she was really leading the game all the time, and in any moment you could really bet on her, because you know Ito Mima could come back all the time. And I think
I was about to say, Galia, we've got a table here, table.
Sure.
I mean, you commentated it.
Yes.
What for you was the main takeout point from that in the victory? What's the thing that stood out for you, if you can illustrate it to the viewers?
Okay. I think if for all those who watch Ito Mima playing, one of her strongest, trademark shots, it's her backhand, right? She has short pimples in her backhand, and what she does with them very well, she plays from backhand, maybe from most part of the table, and she's using her backhand to play very deep on the table, maybe here, sometimes here.
So varying a little bit, but it's always pretty deep in the table.
Yes. But more or less, she usually does the same kind of tactic. First ball comes very deep to one of the corner.
Yep.
Then she pushes her opponent to go a little bit far behind. Her opponent plays her here, and then from this ball, Ito Mima can do two things. Kill you in the opposite side of the table, or play really, really short. But this time, she was trying to do that, but Sun Ying Sha was so quick and so fast that this ball that normally Ito Mima receives here, she was receiving it back here.
So she's less comfortable with it as a result. She's out of her comfort zone as a result, pushed out of it.
And Sun Ying Sha, she was very, very quick with these balls, and she was saving them all the time, pushing Mima Ito back off the table. And for all those who watch Mima Ito play, it's not something that happens quite often. And then plus, Sun Ying Sha, she has a very strong forehand attack that we could see in some of the points in the repetition. And she was being able to turn around from this side and play some bomba winner forehands that Mima Ito, she was not able to catch them.
Yeah, no, absolutely. It was a big big move overall by Sun Ying Sha. I mean, China continue to produce players. She's another one. Moving on, the other match that we've got here, big old match, this defending champion in the men's singles, Ma Long against Vladimir Samsonov, 43 years of age, still evergreen. Omar, you guys know these. I mean, you're in a great place. You know these guys, you know, very, very well. Was it a bit closer than the scoreline ended up 4-1 overall? We'll have a look at a bit of it now.
Yeah, I mean, when you see the score, 4-1, you expect it was easy job for Ma Long, which is not at all. I mean, everyone knows how hard to pass Vladi in the game. I mean, he has a very good control to the ball. He's, for me, he's a living legend, still playing the game, and he's very active playing the World Tours, and he always keep stability of the game and stability of his playing. And I would say that Malong faced very hard challenge to pass Vladi. If you see, it's never end fast with Malong, with Vladi. Malong has to play 1, 2, 3 balls with very good quality to be able to make Vladi lose the point or pass him even, which is not very easy. It's very nice to see Malong is back. You can see last year, sometimes he's back in the Chinese league, or then he can struggle again with some injuries in his body, but very nice to see him again playing big events like the World Championships. Of course, you can expect a lot from him, but the key point when you are playing with Vladi that you need to be 110%.
I mean, you're a tall guy. It feels like you're far away in this studio, but we've got the table again here, Zuccalia. Yeah. For you, you've seen these guys, you've been around them, played around them, you look at that match. What makes Ma Long, I mean, we've said this so many times over the years, but why isn't he losing more now? I mean, at this point, why does it seem like guys are still not getting that close to him at these big events? What is it for you?
I mean, for me, he's Ma Long is the most complete player he in the tour. And to play against Ma Long, you need to also have a very good receive, because Ma Long make incredible good service here short to forehand. And if you are not very good enough here, he will kill you directly with his forehand topspin all over the table. Yeah. So you need to have a very good receive. And also, when he sees you go and receive well, he suddenly make a lot of long service to your middle and to your back. And so you're always hesitating. Should I come in? Should I stay? Mm. When you are playing Malong, I played him two times.
So you kind of end up, if you think about it, you kind of end up nowhere.
Exactly.
A little bit in your footwork, in your movement. Yeah.
And you can see this very clear in the matches between him and Fan Chindong, for example, that Fan Chindong has a marvelous back and flip. And also, Fan Chindong, many times he's very late to come in very fast, because he's aware of the long serves of Malong. So, and of course, if you don't have 100% well received, Malong will kill you with his forehand. Because this is the thing. You need to receive very well against Malong, and you need to also to serve very well against him, so you can at least be away of his forehand topspin. And today with Vladi, it's another story, because Vladi has a very good block and controlling to the game. So Vladi was not afraid of this. Vladi was pushing the ball long all over the table. Malong start and Vladi start to catch 1 or 2 or 3 boys, three balls. And this was not enough for Malong, because he was very, very good today, and he done amazing job. And he was playing the first, second, third ball with all the good quality. So it was a very interesting match for me to see today.
Yeah. I mean, just get Dahlia's thoughts, because I think it's always good to get someone who's involved in the women's event. I mean, you see these guys as well. Get your thoughts. I mean, anything you're finding interesting what Omar is saying there?
Yeah.
You know, overall, I mean, how would you respond?
I mean, I could talk about Ma Long for hours, no? Because he's this classic player that there is nothing that you can say wrong about him. When you look how he plays forehand, it's just perfect. It's just like you want to go there and hug him of how well he's doing that forehand.
He would love that.
I would love that. Or ask him to teach me a
little bit. I'm sure he would appreciate it.
Yeah, no, and also, it's very interesting the point what Omar said, that most of the players, they are very afraid of this forehand topspin, because, come on, it's Malong's forehand topspin. But it's amazing how Vladi, at his age of 43, he doesn't have trouble with this first one. He just goes with the receive.
Well, he's so loose, isn't he, still?
Yeah.
At 40. I mean, it's incredible how he's like balletic movement, you know, in a way. Like a ballet dancer, almost, how he's around the table.
Yeah, but I think that's not only, talent. I'm quite aware that from the years that Vladimir Samsonov, he was living in Spain, he was working a lot in his physicals, and also to keep his balance, because I don't know how is it for tall guys, because I'm definitely not tall, but to control all these bodies, sometimes you see that it's difficult, but when you look at Vladi Samsonov, he's always in position. And it's quite a big achievement.
Yeah, fantastic. Great to get your thoughts on that. Again, of course, remember the fans as well, hashtag LiPairLive on the Twitter and the Facebook. We're going to get to that very, very shortly with you guys asking questions of you, the fans, as I say. Invite the questions on that. In terms of the ITTF, we've got a big old production, our biggest ever production that's been put together. It's called Inside My Mind. We've got loads and loads of top players who are talking specifically about the mental side of the game. And we're going to feature bits and pieces on this all through the week here on Leap Air Live for you. Today, we've got a great example of someone who exudes mental strength, trying to get inside the player's mind, playing a point. It's none other than the former bronze medalist at these World Championships, former world number one, talking about his mental game, Germany's Timo Boll.
Es gibt nicht die eine Lösung für alles. Aber alles ist lösbar. Ist es Kraft, Geschwindigkeit oder Spin? Entscheide dich. Der Gegner setzt zur Vorhand an. Seine Position distanziert. Sein Stil aggressiv. Meine Lösung: viel Rotation in seine Rückhand. Los. Schläger zum Knie. Handgelenk für maximalen Spin. Mit vollem Körpereinsatz. Vielversprechend.
Yeah, really good to get inside the mind of Timo Boll there, and as I say, lots more of that to come in the week. Another thing that we've got this week that really excites the players, we're going to get your thoughts, Galia and Omar, on this, is the Tata trick shot. Of course, Tata been a key sponsor, partner of the ITTF over the last couple of years, the wooden door, and it serves as the background for these ridiculous, amazing Tata trick shots. And today, in our latest installment, I thought about trying to explain this, but it's just too difficult. I think we're just going to roll the video here. It's Adriana Diaz, first Latin American woman to reach the round of 32 here at a World Championships here in Budapest this week. Adriana's been taking on, as I say, I just roll the video.
Hi, I'm Adriana Diaz, and this is my trick shot.
Guys, what did you make of that?
Wonderful.
It's so wonderful. She's so talented and she makes it so easy.
Yeah, she's not just good at the match.
I just don't want the audience to think that it's coming in a very short time. They need to practice so long.
You've done a Tata trick
shot,
haven't you, Emma?
Yes, yeah. I have done this 2 days ago and I have stayed so long time because, yes.
How many hours?
I would say I stayed, I think, around 28 minutes, I would say, yeah. And this, he said, okay, this isn't the average. It's not so long, not so little. And then he said, okay, for me, it was a very hard challenge. I need to roll the ball around the net with forehand and then roll it around the table with back and open the doors. And then I have to do this Asar boom with they make the high and this special shot. I have to do it and I have to do it all together in a row. And for me, it was, come on, you must be kidding. I cannot do this all in one time. And they said, no, but we stay how long it takes. And it takes 28 minutes, which for me was so exhausting. The guy was so patient. I told him, okay, sorry, I'm not that talented. So you have to be patient with me. It was a very, very nice time, yes. But yeah, at the end, I opened the three doors and I was very happy.
Greatest moment of your life.
Yes.
We're going to get to the questions in a moment. We're a couple of minutes away, by the way, from hashtag LeapHerLive, the Twitter and the Facebook for Omar and Galia. Just a word from you on the Tata trick shot. You haven't done it yet.
No, I haven't.
It's top of your to-do list, I guess.
I'm not sure. Now that I heard that it takes so long to do them, I thought that they were just naturals and it worked so fast. Yeah. But now that I know that it takes a long time, I maybe will get too nervous in the moment.
Yeah, no, absolutely. We'll get you on it, Galia, absolutely. Let's move on. We've been promising it. We've got not much time left, actually, before the session. I'm going to load up my live feed now because we've had the questions pouring in for you, Omar, and for you, Galia. Let's get straight to it. Hashtag LeapHerLive if you want to try and get them in. We'll try and get you in. Not much time now through the Twitter and the Facebook, something we're doing all the way through the week. Let's get straight to it. First of all, the World Championships announcements the next few years. We knew about Busan next year for the next team. I want to ask you too about the States the year after that. You heard it along with all the other players. Yeah. I mean, this is big news because was it the last 82 years, only Europe and Asia?
Yeah.
What was your immediate reaction when you heard Houston, Texas had got the World Championship?
I want to go there. I will keep playing. I've been playing national team for 15, 16 years. Okay, I will keep playing two more years just to go there. And it was my sincere reaction. I really would love to see an event of this magnitude in the States, because normally how they organize things in US, it's always so big and so spectacular. And I think for table tennis, it's such a big opportunity to go there.
We'll get through another one here if I can load it up, Omar, here. If you could describe, Omar, these World Championships, you've been here, in three words, what would they be?
Exciting,
yep.
Amazing, and dangerous. Dangerous because you cannot stop watching.
I thought you'd seen Hugo Calderano's trick shot attempt. He broke a camera lens.
Did he?
Well, maybe not quite broke it. Scratched it.
Okay, but still.
This is dangerous.
Still is dangerous. Yeah.
For you, Galia, quickly, three words.
My personal experience was disappointing because of the results. And then interesting because I love table tennis. And warm because it was very warm.
Yeah, yeah, no, absolutely.
It's crazy.
As I say, we've kind of run out of time on that and the questions, but we're going to be doing it throughout the rest of the week. Hashtag Lipe Live. We'll get the best of your questions to all our guests through the course of the rest of the week. Just remains for us, we're just, what is it, a few minutes away from 4 o'clock here in our local time in Budapest, to look ahead to what we've got in the session coming up. Just picking out a couple of big matches for you and get a couple of brief thoughts with you before we close. I mean, the big one for you, Omar, here, you look at here, table one. Simon Gauzy, the Frenchman, against the Cloudwalker, China's Xu Xin. Are you looking forward to that?
I'm so much looking forward, since Simon was playing so awesome yesterday. He won very tough two games and he was playing amazing. Also, Xu Xin was playing so many fishing and around the table and running. And this is so, we are going to see so awesome rallies. I think the fans are going to love it this afternoon. Absolutely, I'm going towards this match.
And we've also got a lot of other stuff. I mean, that's the big highlight match, but there's a load of doubles is carrying on. And then this evening, Galia, women's singles. Big matches.
Yes, big matches. But also today, men's singles, I think Matthias Karlsson is facing Thiago Apollonia. So this will be also
very
a very
nice
interesting
match.
One.
Good match.
Yeah, very
interesting match. But I mean, I will be sitting here all afternoon when I will not be commentating, so I will be watching everything again.
It's a lot to look forward to and everything.
True.
I guess you two can look back on it now.
Dong as well is playing. Yeah.
We could keep going on, couldn't we?
Just stay here.
Sure.
Stay here and look forward.
Thanks very, very much for being on, as I say, everything. Before we go, Lipe would like to give you a gift for coming on.
Thank you.
If I can get them out here.
Oi.
Omar, I'm going to have to reach over to you.
Oh.
Little gift for you here.
Thank you.
From our title sponsor, Lipe Live. And Galia, same for you as well.
Thank you very much.
I always like guests to open these because otherwise the viewer is just left wondering. So go on and be really, really aggressive, like you're hitting a forehand here. Come on.
No, I'm not aggressive.
Come on. Rip it open. It's wrapping paper.
Oh, wow.
That's too nice.
I was thinking it's something like this.
Yeah.
Really?
Come on.
Yes.
This is fantastic.
Wait for Omar here. So you can show them to the camera here.
This
the gift.
Is very nice.
So we're wondering here, we've got these here. Just a clue here, it might end up looking like this.
This will be a trick shot, actually. If we stand here, and we try to hit the ball.
Maybe we can invite you back on when you try to put it together. Because I hear they're quite difficult. It's quite a challenge. It's a bit like a puzzle, a jigsaw. But it's meant to look like that eventually.
Thank
so I hope you have good fun with that. And thank you very, very much for, being part of things here on Leaphead Live. Great to have you with us, Omar Assar and Galia Dvorak. Thanks very, very much for joining us here on Lipe Live. As I said, we're going to be back after the evening session with another edition, this behind-the-scenes look throughout the week from here in Budapest. Thank you for your company. As I said, we'll see you later on this evening to round up all the action from here on Wednesday at these Lipe 2019 ITTF World Table Tennis Championships. For now, as I say, enjoy the action. We'll see you later.